Hello everyone, and welcome to a new game called Kerbal Space Program. If you haven't ever heard of this game, you kind of just build your own spacecraft and, I don't know, any sort of vehicle, and you get to explore space and the Earth and the universe and everything around it. Everything around the universe, that makes sense. I just want to get right into it. I'm going to resume my save right here. I'm going to show you what I have done right now, because I've played this game a little bit. So far, all I've done to experiment, I started to make a space shuttle, or my own design of a space shuttle that would fly in the game. And this is what I came up with. sorry, my voice is kind of... I guess next episode or later this episode, we'll get into actually how you build stuff, but I just want to showcase this first. I'll give you a little feel. You can build your spacecraft, and then you go to the launch pad, and you can launch. We'll clear the launch pad. Come on. There we go. Let's change the time. Whoa. Alright, so when I mess with the time warp, the engines kind of go funky for some reason. But what we want to do, we're going to put our throttle up. I guess I'm not going to set it to daytime. And press T, which turns on this SAS, which is like autopilot. And you can see when it does that, like all of our engines start like shaking and that'll start going crazy. It's because I built this off balance and it's trying its best to stay on balance. So anyways, we're going to go ahead and launch. I'm going to press spacebar. And this is what's going to happen. For every spacebar press, there's like little sections. So the first time, all this stuff is going to happen. Then the next time, this is going to happen. So these are engines. So when I press spacebar, these engines are going to start boosting. And then also, these stability things are going to let go. And these engines on this back here are going to also. And then I'll get to these once we're up in the air. So let's launch. If you didn't have SAS on, you have to kind of... Oops, sorry about that, I got a message. If we didn't have SAS, I'd have to control it, and it was pretty hard to control it. As you can see, we're starting to overheat, so I'm going to throttle down a little bit by pressing control, and it kind of cools down a little bit. These are our fuel tanks, how much fuel we have left. What I have back here are fuel pumps, so even though this engine's boosting, it's using the fuel from these. That way I can split off these white ones, these white fuel rockets, which are right here. We'll get to that next. This thing, this middle one, the orange one, will still have fuel in it, if you understand. That's what they do on the space shuttle, except I don't think the orange one actually fires. I'm not sure. I don't know. And also, the space shuttle fuel's being used. We're about to run out of fuel, actually, so let's prepare. And when I press spacebar, these should just fly off of it. And they run out just like that. Once this orange rocket starts to run out of fuel, something funky happens. I haven't perfected this design yet. Let's throttle down. Go about here. Something funky happens. It starts to just lean back. Like it starts to curve this way. And it's very hard to control, and it'll crash. So I don't know how to fix that exactly yet, but I'm still working on this, and we can work on it together throughout the series. I want to make this a series. It's a really fun game. This first episode will just kind of be showing you what I've done and how we could progress. And if you've played this game before, please leave suggestions and whatever on building styles and what we can do to... Oops, I meant to throttle up. What we can do to perfect... see, there it starts to lean back. And it's very hard to control, so I'm just going to deploy. And now it's just our space shuttle, and it'll start flipping around, because this doesn't have perfect balance either. Can't really control. I'll turn off autopilot, and I'll try controlling it, but it's very difficult. And then also what I can do, I have this last section, which is a parachute. So when we shut off all our engines, we would fall back to Earth, but we're so high, it'll take so long to fall. I don't want to waste your time. But then we have a parachute, and it would deploy in the little cockpit with all the little Kermans in it. Would fall safely back to Earth. So that's the first rocket I worked on. That took me a while to learn, actually. It was very hard to get the balance right, and well, my voice is really dry. Sorry about that. took me a while to kind of, I don't want to say perfect it, but get it to how it is. I also have, this is my current project that I think we'll work on next episode. Where is it? It's going to be first Moon Lander. So there's a moon circling the Earth, or Kerman, or whatever this planet is, called the Moon, and it's basically a moon, and this is what I built to try to get to it, but it needs some work. Let's test this out real quick. So what we want to do first is throttle up, turn on SAS, and proceed. It's very wobbly, as you can see. And it literally cannot wobble more than that without detaching. Oh, better throttle down. That's overheating quick. So yeah, this needs a lot of work. But what we're trying to do is get a lander onto what is it? This, the Moon. We can set that as target, but I mean, we're not going to get to it right now. There's also, just to give you what we want to explore, there's the Moon, then there's Minmus. This is also a moon of the Earth, or Kerbal, whatever. But then there's also space. Like, there's a lot to explore. But for right now, we're going to stick to landing on the Moon, because it's the closest. I hear it's actually not the easiest. I hear Minmus is a lot easier to land on from watching other people's videos, but I want to go to the Moon. I don't know, I think we'll just progressively work our way out, and it'll kind of get easier if, depending on how we do it. Like, it'll be easier to... Whoa. Oh. Well, there went that. Can also detach from that and use this rocket. This rocket still doesn't have good balance either, but this is the rocket, once we get out into space, that's going to help us get to the Moon, supposedly, my plan. And then once this runs out of fuel, we can detach from that. It's detached, but it's just staying there because that rocket's pushing. But then also what we can do is detach the nose cone to help balance out the weight, and we can use why is that still stuck on us? That's annoying me. Our little nose cone's still stuck on there too. There we go, now it's detached, but now we're spinning out of control. But what this is our actual lander, and this will help us land on the Moon. If it'll stop spinning out of control, I can kind of, I'm controlling it now. Try getting it to face up. It's, controls are inverted for me right now, so it's kind of difficult to, have to press the keys in whatever direction it's going. But as it's falling to Earth, or supposedly the moon, if we ever get there, the moon, as we ever get there, there goes part of our rocket. Start landing. Oh, we're gonna land over the ocean, but I can turn these rockets up to help slow us down. And I can also lower these landing struts. And that's what the actual rocket will sit on. And I can deploy these little Kermans to go down the ladder and actually explore the moon. Or the moon. Looks like our ladder actually broke off. I might have to fix that. It's getting very hard to control. There we go. Now we can throttle down progressively to slow us down more. And the idea is to go so slowly where we just barely land in the moon without any impact to hurt a rocket or anything. And I haven't thought of a way back, so we'll have to work on that. Still not exactly. There we go, now we're pretty flat. I'm gonna fall more. I kind of turned on my rockets a little early, so we want to be closer to the Earth when we, so we don't run out of fuel before, because then we'd fall and crash. So I guess as we get closer and closer to the water, if you land in the water, I assume the Kermans die because they no longer you just lose contact. So there we go. We're starting to this is our actual velocity. Oh, I started to go up. So we're going 27 meters per second. I'm going up. I don't want to be going up. That's the problem I have. I turn the throttle up too much and then we start to go up. That's not what I want. Oh. Anyways, that's basically what I have done, and we're going to work on that next episode. We're going to work on our Moonlander, and I need your suggestions for good ideas for this, because right now it's not really good at all. But anyways, thank you for watching. Join me next time on Kerbal Space Program, and hopefully we'll get to the Moon next episode. I doubt it, but high hopes, high hopes.